In this video, we will cover email validation. So to validate if it's the correct email address. So I'll first put a text input and we will name it text input underscore email. Then we'll put its label for the message. And the message for it, enter valid email address format. Remember, we cannot validate if it's the right email address. We can validate the format. So you should enter valid email address format. Now the color of this will be red. And visible will be variable show email label. Then on submit, we will put update context. Oh, I have this in my copy buffer. Variable show email. If this is the function, if is match. And this is the content which we are getting from the text box, text input. We are matching the email. If the email matches, don't show the error label, else you show the error label. Once again, variable show email label. If the match happens, is match is a Power Apps built-in function, and match.email, there are numerous possibilities of matching which we'll see in the future video, but at the moment we are doing a match.email. So if the match happens, if it's a valid email match, we don't want to show the label, so false else true. Okay, once we do this, then we will work on the reset button. In the reset, we will do a reset of the text input underscore email. Done. Now we'll do update context. How will this take this? Show email label false. Because once we reset it, show email label false. Okay, good. Let's test it. One thing remaining, we don't need this. Let's test it. We click here submit. We put something here, so we don't get this error 21. We don't get that error. Remember, this is the continuation from the previous lessons. alum@yahoo.com. Submit, no error message. Submit, yahoo.com. Submit, not valid. .oi. Submit valid .au. I don't know which country is OI, okay? I'm just guessing it. It's just guess. No offense. Okay. Now submit. All three errors will validate @aaa.aaa. Remember, this may not be a valid email, but this is still a valid email format. So it will not give error. We type something here, submit, we type 18, so no error here. So once again, we do this match. This variable is set to false if the match happen. Is match is the function which will match the text in the email, text input email, against the match.email. Match.email is the variable, is the built-in enumerator which will do the matching of this text against the email address format. And this is match will return false or true depending on the match. That's it.